One of SpaceX's most revolutionary projects is taking shape above us, a constellation of satellites known as Starlink. In this video, we will tell you about the economic significance these tiny satellites hold for SpaceX. From its inception to the latest developments, we will explore how Starlink has become a game changer in the quest for global broadband internet coverage. The cosmos is calling, and the future of connectivity is being shaped among the stars. How Elon Musk's Starlink is bringing billions for SpaceX. Starlink project, from paper to reality. Launched by SpaceX, Starlink is more than just a collection of satellites in the sky. It's a bold endeavor to bring high-speed internet to every corner of the globe. Imagine a web of satellites, not high above in the distant reaches of space, but in low Earth orbit, creating a dynamic network designed to beam internet connectivity directly to your doorstep. Starlink's mission is nothing short of ambitious: to provide high-speed, low-latency internet access to users around the world, even in the most remote areas. How does SpaceX do that? Simple, with a constellation. The constellation is made up of thousands of small satellites, each equipped with advanced technology, working in harmony to deliver a seamless internet experience. But how did we get here? Let's take a quick look back at Starlink's journey from concept to reality. Born out of the need for global connectivity, Starlink went from an idea on paper to a fully operational satellite constellation. In 2015, SpaceX officially announced the project, but the initial concept faced skepticism and challenges. Critics questioned the feasibility of deploying thousands of satellites, and yet Elon Musk and his team persisted. Fast forward to 2018, and SpaceX launched the first batch of Starlink satellites. This marked the beginning of an unprecedented endeavor, a mission that would redefine how we perceive satellite internet. The subsequent years witnessed a flurry of activity as SpaceX conducted multiple launches, rapidly expanding the Starlink constellation. Falcon 9 rockets became a familiar sight in the night sky, carrying dozens of Starlink satellites to their designated orbits. By 2021, Starlink had achieved significant coverage, and beta testing commenced in select regions. Users reported remarkable improvements in internet speed and reliability, validating the project's potential. As of today in 2023, however, there are nearly 9,000 active satellites, with active Starlinks making up the overwhelming majority of them, 4,755 out of the 8,647 active satellites, or 55% of them. As the constellation grew, however, so did the challenges. Coordination of thousands of satellites in low Earth orbit required precise planning to avoid collisions and space debris. Yet, with each challenge, SpaceX adapted and overcame. For instance, Starlink satellites avoid collisions through onboard AI software that tells them how to move. Unfortunately, though, if that software gets knocked offline, such as by a solar storm, SpaceX has no protections against this catastrophe. In any case, today Starlink is not just a vision on paper, it's a tangible reality, connecting users across the globe and demonstrating the power of human ingenuity when coupled with a bold vision. Unlike traditional satellites in geostationary orbit, Starlink's LEO satellites are closer to the Earth's surface, resulting in reduced latency and faster internet speeds. This proximity to Earth, combined with an advanced phased array antenna technology on the ground, makes Starlink a forerunner in the race to redefine global internet accessibility. Starlink, economic impact. Now let's shift our focus from the stars to the ledgers and explore the economic impact of Starlink on SpaceX. Beyond its cosmic ambitions, Starlink has proven to be a financial powerhouse, playing a pivotal role in fueling the coffers of SpaceX. SpaceX, under the visionary leadership of Elon Musk, has always had its eyes set on the future of space exploration. However, it's Starlink, the satellite internet constellation, that has brought not just global connectivity, but a substantial boost to SpaceX's bottom line. One of the key contributors to SpaceX's revenue stream is the business model crafted around Starlink. The sale of Starlink services and equipment, including the Starlink dish and user terminals, has become a significant source of income for the aerospace giant. The subscription-based model employed by Starlink, offering different service plans to users, has created a steady and recurring revenue. Users worldwide are subscribing to Starlink for its promise of high-speed internet, especially in areas with limited connectivity. Starlink now boasts millions of subscribers globally. This substantial user base not only represents a technological triumph, but also a substantial economic triumph for SpaceX. The 2022 year revenue was over $1 billion higher than in 2021, when Starlink generated $222 million. Satellites are therefore bringing in $1.2 billion. But this is still way below the initial company's expectations, as Elon Musk himself said. Moreover, according to the report from 8 years ago, the company expected to have 20 million subscribers to its satellite internet service by the end of 2023. But in September, the company only had 2 million subscribers. So the company's growth is going worse than expected. But what about the bottom line? The revenue generated by Starlink has not only supported the ongoing operations of SpaceX, but has also injected vital funds into the company's ambitious projects, including the development of the Starship spacecraft for interplanetary travel. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Starlink. Coverage versus availability. No matter where you are, Starlink's satellite is likely traversing the skies above you, ready to beam high-speed internet. However, the accessibility to Starlink services is not as straightforward as its global coverage might suggest. While the reach of Starlink's satellite coverage spans the entire planet, service availability hinges on a complex interplay of factors. The term we use here is service availability, a measure of whether Starlink officially extends its products and services to a specific location. Let's break it down. Starlink service availability is typically delineated by country. For instance, as of now, Starlink does not offer its products or services in many countries across Africa. You can't purchase a service plan or a dish if your address is in Morocco, for example. However, here's the interesting twist. You could bring a Starlink dish purchased in Europe and use it in Morocco with the right service plan. Now the question arises, why this geographic discrepancy? The answer lies in a multitude of factors, with regulatory approval being a significant player. Starlink must navigate the regulatory landscape of each country, working closely with their governments to secure the necessary approvals to operate. An illustrative example of Starlink's adaptive role unfolded in 2022 during the Russian invasion of Ukraine. Amidst the conflict, Ukraine, facing severe degradation of internet and communication networks, reached out to SpaceX, Starlink's parent company, for help. In response, SpaceX activated Starlink's satellite internet service in the country. This deployment proved pivotal for civilians, the government, and the military, serving both humanitarian and defense purposes. Starlink became a beacon of connectivity amid the challenges of war. However, it's essential to note that Starlink's global presence comes with its own set of geopolitical challenges. Some countries like China and Russia actively block Starlink services. In such cases, Starlink may choose to discontinue coverage to avoid legal or political confrontations. So while Starlink's constellation blankets the Earth, the ability to connect isn't universal. The decision to enable or disable connections in specific areas rests in the hands of Starlink, showcasing the intricate dance between technology, geopolitics, and the pursuit of global connectivity. Starlink controversies. While Starlink has soared to great heights, it hasn't been without its share of controversies, some of which orbit the concerns of astronomers who gaze into the cosmos. One of the primary concerns raised by astronomers is the impact of Starlink on the night sky. The sheer number of satellites in the Starlink constellation has led to increased satellite visibility during the night, creating streaks of light that traverse astronomers' observations. This phenomena has sparked worries about light pollution. The steady stream of Starlink satellites passing through the field of view can complicate the study of stars, galaxies, and other celestial objects. This has ignited a discourse between the scientific community and SpaceX regarding measures to mitigate the impact of satellite constellations on astronomical observations. In response to these concerns, SpaceX has taken steps to address the issue. They've initiated measures such as darkening the satellites, experimenting with sunshades, and exploring satellite orbits that minimize their visibility during certain hours. While the gaze of worry extends beyond the astronomical realms, another area of concern revolves around the growing issue of space debris generated by satellite launches. The expanding constellation of satellites in low Earth orbit triggers contemplation about the lasting sustainability of this new era in space exploration. Consider our earlier discussion about the AI collision avoidance system embedded in Starlink satellites. In recent months, an alarming surge in collision avoidance maneuvers has prompted heightened apprehension. With thousands of new spacecraft slated for launch in the coming years, the question of sustainability looms large. According to SpaceX, their broadband satellites executed more than 25,000 collision avoidance maneuvers between December 1, 2022 and May 31, 2023. Since the launch of the first Starlink spacecraft in 2019, these maneuvers have surpassed 50,000, with the frequency doubling every 6 months. If this trajectory persists, by 2028, Starlink satellites may need to execute nearly a million maneuvers in half a year to mitigate the risk of orbital collisions. Yet the challenges don't end there. Among the Starlink satellites, there are some that can no longer perform collision avoidance. Elon Musk himself has acknowledged post-launch failures, although the precise number of non-functional satellites remains undisclosed. Estimates suggesting that around 3% of deployed Starlink satellites have encountered issues, stemming from deployment anomalies, on-orbit collisions, or technical malfunctions. These failures, while a small percentage, underscore the inherent complexities and risks associated with the vast celestial network. It is becoming increasingly clear that the pursuit of technological progress must be balanced with meticulous consideration for the sustainability of Earth's orbital environment. The future of Starlink. The impressive growth trajectory exhibited by Starlink faces imminent challenges for several reasons. As Brent Prokosh, senior affiliate consultant at Euroconsult, said, there's a saturation of demand, especially in markets where the service has been available for approximately 2 years. The initial wave of subscribers, those most eager for enhanced service, has likely already transitioned to Starlink. Evidence suggests that to sustain demand, Starlink has resorted to reducing the costs of its user terminals. Promotional efforts have seen baseline costs in the US, typically around $600, slashed to as low as $150 in Canada's rural areas, and similar adjustments in localized campaigns in Australia and Japan. While these measures indicate a proactive approach to maintaining market interest, they also hint at the saturation challenges faced by the company. Moreover, Starlink's success is strictly linked to SpaceX's ambitious project Starship. This next-generation reusable rocket is actually critical for Starlink's continued growth, because it is larger and more powerful than the current Falcon 9 rockets currently used to launch Starlink satellites. Starship is therefore essential for both expanding the satellite network and replacing aging satellites over time. This is the reason why delays in its development pose a hurdle for SpaceX to sustain the rapid expansion seen thus far. Adding to the challenges, competition in the consumer satellite internet market is intensifying. Amazon's Project Kuiper, a formidable contender, launched its first satellite prototypes in October. Expected to initiate beta testing with customers by the end of 2024, Project Kuiper mirrors Starlink's vertical integration approach, manufacturing its satellites and launching them via its affiliated company, Blue Origin. As the satellite internet landscape evolves, the dynamics of competition, technological advancement, and market saturation will play pivotal roles in shaping the future of Starlink and its counterparts. The path ahead is marked by both challenges and opportunities in the pursuit of universal connectivity. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Ever had the chance to see Starlink satellites piled up, floating above you in the night sky? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.